Well, it turns out not that much. It actually uses less power than my gaming PC, but I think that says more about how inefficient these machines have gotten rather than how little the scooter uses. But anyway, this is my Apollo City Pro, and I wondered how much electricity I use riding it on a daily basis, which should take some simple math to figure out, starting with how much it takes to charge. I could have easily looked at the battery capacity on the manufacturer website, but the capacity doesn't necessarily tell us how much electricity will be used when charging it. And that's because no process is 100% efficient. So while charging, some of that energy will be expressed in the form of heat. And anyone who has plugged one of these into the wall knows that they can get quite warm. So to find out how much it actually takes to run this thing, I used my trusty power meter. Taking just shy of 6 hours to charge, we see the light go green on the power brick. The meter reports 0.935 kilowatt hours of energy used, which is equivalent to about an hour and a half of gaming on my computer, 45 minutes of running the space heater, driving an electric car for a few kilometers, or running your dryer for just 20 minutes. So that's for a full charge. I only have to ride about 9.5 kilometers a day for my commute, so I get an average of about 36 kilometers per charge on this scooter. So after some math, I consume about 0.247 kilowatt hours a day. So all those comparisons I said earlier, just like cut them into quarters. But that might not resonate with everyone. What I think does is the cost. How much does it actually cost to ride this thing? It's not actually here. I don't really have the space for it. A bunch of crap over there. But anyway, we already know how much it takes to charge. We just need to multiply it by the cost of electricity. So here in BC, the base rate per kilowatt hour is 9.5 cents. And I could just use that, but I want to be as fair as possible. So I went ahead and looked at my hydro bills for 2022 and calculated the average paid per kilowatt hour, which includes an upcharge after a certain threshold, daily minimum charges, and taxes. All said, the average cost per kilowatt hour for me was 11.8 cents. So that's 11.8 cents by our 0.935 kilowatt hours. Actually, I think we're gonna just, for the sake of argument, let's just round it off to 0.95 kilowatt hours. So 11.8 cents by 0.95 kilowatt hours gets a whopping total of 11.2 cents per charge. That's right, an average range of 36 kilometers per charge for just 11 cents. But let's take it a bit further. My commute is on the shorter side, and as it turns out, the median commute in Vancouver is actually a round trip of 14.8 kilometers. So divide our full charge cost of 11.2 cents by the average range, 36 kilometers, and we get a cost of 0.3 cents per kilometer. Multiply by 14.8, and the average commuter will be looking at a daily electricity cost of 4.6 cents, which is about 92 cents a month, or for a year of commuting, $11.08. So that's just commuting to work 5 days a week for 48 weeks, because most people have a few weeks off every year. But let's say you're happy to use your scoot outside commuting like I am, maybe an average of 25 kilometers a week for 52 weeks adds an additional $4.05, giving us a total of $15.13 Canadian bucks. Let that sink in. $15.13 will take you to work and back every single day, along with getting you around outside of work for groceries, visiting friends, or whatever. That's one Uber ride. Like, one way. You're walking back. That's ridiculous. Like, I was actually shocked by how cheap it is. And to top it off, this isn't even an efficient scooter. Single motor scooters will actually knock off about 30% from that. So in comparison, the Apollo City Pro taking that 0.935 kilowatt hours, my 9-bot Max used just shy of 0.6 kilowatt hours, and it gets a similar range. But all that being said, the energy here in BC is notoriously cheap. We get the vast majority of our electricity from dams, which is not only a relatively cheap way to generate electricity, it's also pretty clean. So let's translate that cost to other places around the world. So me in Vancouver, that's 15.13 Canadian, which is about 11.28 USD a year. Just 500 kilometers south in Oregon, you'll pay around $15.25. And on the other side of the continent, in New York, $29.82. Over in Asia, the Japanese will pay about 4,316 yen, while Koreans may expect a bill not too far from myself of 14,858 won. In the UK, that'll be £51.29. And across the English Channel, you may pay around 41 to 39 euros. In the Netherlands, well, up in Denmark, it'll be bumped up to around 64.21. And that's actually around the price I thought it would be, around $60 or something like that. So even there in Europe, in Denmark, one of the most expensive places to get electricity, it's still pretty decent. And on the extremes, you'll find many small island nations such as the Solomon Islands, where the lowest estimate will be about 944 Solomon Island dollars, or 115.28 USD. So all of those numbers are based on the commute here in Vancouver, that average of 14.8. There are so many variables that are going to change that price. And that's the cost of electricity, efficiency of the scooter, weight of the rider, riding style, topography, and many other factors. But at the end of the day, granted you don't live on a small island that needs to import coal and gas to produce that electricity, these nifty little machines are incredibly cheap to run, which of course doesn't include the cost and upkeep of the scooter, which will be the subject of a different video. So if you want to see more, get subscribed. And with that, my name is Nick. Thanks for watching.